number 322. We're going to do all verses and you can remain seated.
Inside of God. not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. Everyone who acknowledges me before others, I will acknowledge before my Heavenly Father. But whoever denies me before others, I will deny before my Heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, O Christ.
In my bulletin, where humanity got its start. And God brought his beauty to the garden in which he brought his greatest gift, the gift of love. As we have seen in the past weeks, it feels like we've been on a teeter-totter. Some of us are old enough to know what a teeter-totter is. Where we've tried to balance things out, not only with the virus in our personal life, but also in the comfort of our own homes, we have once again found God's love. We have once again realized the love of family and friends. We have gone through some very difficult times. And through those difficult times, it has been made less difficult just because of the love that we have surrounding us. I was thinking as I was doing my morning prayers, I'm not an electronics person. If it don't wind up or run by gas, I can't work it. And I was thinking how important it was that man discovered cell phones and computers prior to this pandemic. Look at how much more tolerant that made us of the world in which we live. That we could keep aware of everything that was going on in our world, and we could communicate with people we love, both near and far. And God's wisdom continues in our world. Our Father in heaven, his wisdom pervades our world. And yet, I know so many people that believe that they're the fount of wisdom, only to find out they really aren't. And we always tend to get a comeuppance with our wisdom. Like the young man today that gave me the high sign. He got a blessing. And he received that blessing. He knew he had done wrong, and now every time he does that, he'll remember what happened at the blinking light in Spencer, New York. Someday there might be one of those state markers there for that. Our Father. give thanks for the Father we knew as our Father who created us. There was times I was so angry with my Father because I didn't understand. And that anger did more harm to me than it did anyone else. And the only way I could overcome that anger was through forgiveness. And with the things that had happened, it was a very difficult thing to forgive. A very difficult thing to say, I'll forget about these past 20 years, and I forgive you. Forgiveness is one of the only ways we can overcome anger. One of the only ways to overcome anger is through forgiveness. And we carry within our souls wounds that have been caused by our interactions with people. We carry within our souls sometimes things that we need to let go of through forgiveness. Today's gospel reading tells us, don't let people hurt you. Try to understand where they're coming from. Don't let them hurt you, and most of all, don't let them hurt your soul. Because your soul is the Spirit of God that dwells in you. Your soul is the Spirit of God that dwells in you. And you have an innate goodness within yourself. We all have regrets. We all have sorrows. But we also all have joys that are brought about by the love that God has given us. So let us continue to walk in that love. It truly is the greatest gift. Often you'll see the sign, God is love. And that's exactly what Jesus discovered in his young life, that God is love. And he walked in that love and wanted us to follow that example. And there, 2,000 years later, we still come together to walk in love and to know and understand God's goodness. So let us go forth in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Let us share together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said it is more blessed to give than to receive.
Our offertory hymn is number 52.
Thank you.
come for us, the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We ask God's blessing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us prepare ourselves to receive the sacrament of Holy Communion as we pray for all of Christ's church and the world. God, we come before your altar this day, asking for forgiveness for any sins or offenses that we have done against you, our God, against your creation, against our neighbors, or against ourselves. We ask forgiveness for these our sins. We give thanks for all that you have given us, for our family and for our friends, for our church and our parish family, for our community, the state, the nation, and the world in which we live. Help us to preserve your creation for the generations yet to come, that they too may be partakers of your kingdom here on earth as in heaven. We pray for all people who cannot be with us, especially for the sick and the suffering, and for all people for whom our prayers are now desired. Jannie Red Sicker, Alyssa Van Poole, Dorothy Middle, Donald Lesch, Beth O'Donnell, Joe Brennan, Steve Frazier, Ann Price, Galios Moika, Connie Siapa, Nancy Zamoyski, Kathy Garrett, Katie Ahart, Katie Smith, Larry Pataky, Jackie Pataky, TJ Hart, Barry Craddock, George Bowen, Jerry Gentile, Cynthia Halstead, Cindy Burdick, Helen Winters, Terry Collins, Joseph Robert Cass, Ward Hungerford, Jack Carr, Richard Vinskoy, Gloria Kunzman, Bob Wilcox, Dan Jackson, Mary Burkle, Craig, Lori Blow, Diane Craig, Martha Brewster, Bill Palmer, Sally Marks, Ed Gilbert, Sue Rice, Mary Louise Collins, Shelby Hager, Betty Hurst. We trust through faith that you will touch them with your healing power. We also pray for all those who are trying to make decisions to return to their professions, to return to their jobs, to overcome the directions that perhaps the pandemic has brought to them. I pray especially for my friend Alex. Open the doors that need to be opened for these people, especially the young people graduating, that their goals can be accomplished, and that you will open the doors for them to know and understand your will for them, and to share their gifts and their talents with our world. We pray for all those who have died in the hope of the resurrection. We pray especially this day for your servant Bobby Holden, and we trust through faith that you have opened your arms in love and mercy and received him into your heavenly kingdom. Be with his family and friends as they mourn their loss, that their empty hearts may be filled with the consolation of your love and the joyful memories they have shared throughout the years. And now together, let us confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in our thoughts, in our words, and in our deeds.
Psalms number 237, and we'll do verses 1 and 3.